Thank you. Good evening to all of you. So over the next few minutes, I'm going to describe as to why phakic intraocular lenses are my solution for all refractive errors. I have no financial disclosure. Now, there are a couple of characteristics of the phakic intraocular lens which make it my procedure of choice. The lens is biologically inert. It has a better optical quality, a larger optic zone, and higher efficacy and stability as compared to the keratorefractive procedures. Now, what makes this lens inert? We all know that the collamer has a high affinity for the fibronectin in the aqueous, which forms a layer on the lens and subsequently protects it from the inflammatory mediators in the aqueous. You can see that an acrylic lens, which is routinely used in cataract surgery, has a dense protein deposition within a minute of exposure, as against the near absence of proteins on the surface of the collamer. Now, one of the disadvantages of placing an implant in the eye might be that the internal reflectance would result in secondary images and result in photoic phenomena such as glare and halos. However, the internal reflectance of the collamer is the same as the crystalline lens, and it does not result in excessive amount of glare and halos postoperatively, which is not the case in ablations following keratorefractive procedures. The quality of vision as against the MTF, the Stearns ratio, and the OSI have shown that the quality of eyes undergoing this phakic IOL implant is the same as that of a normal eye. The higher order aberrations again are significantly lower as compared to other implants, including silicone, Acrysoft, and the Sensar lenses. Now, one of the most important advantages would be an enlargement of the optic zone on the cornea. The effective optic zone is 1.25 times the optic zone of the lens, which means that while we're treating powers of up to 13.5, we can give the patient an optic zone of 7 millimeters or greater, which is not at all possible with any corneal-based procedure. Now, my opponent may say that the complications including cataract are one of the potential drawbacks. However, with the advent of the central hole models, the 360 degree micron hole allows a good movement of the aqueous, and the rates of complications such as cataract have drastically reduced. They also allow a lower vault, and studies have successfully shown the implantation of phakic IOLs in AC depths as low as 2.4 millimeters over a 4-year follow-up. Now, Cochrane reviews have also shown that the phakic IOL vis-a-vis the excimer laser has a greater efficacy, a better safety, and a better contrast for both moderate as well as high myopia. Again, a number of studies have shown that even in low myopia, the performance is equivalent to the high myopia, and the higher order aberration profile is definitely significantly better than laser vision correction. Now, one can argue that these lenses are more costly to the patient. However, the Indian varieties cost the same as the femtosecond laser as well as the SMILE procedures. Additionally, there is nil initial investment for the surgeon, wherein one does not need to spend money on the femtosecond or the excimer platform, and no additional surgical training is required, and any surgeon who is comfortable with cataract and the anterior segment can do this procedure with great ease. Special situations like corneal ectasias, both idiopathic and iatrogenic, patients who've undergone an intracorneal ring segment implantation, or patients with a lamellar keratoplasty can also undergo these phakic implants to correct their refractive errors, while this obviously is a contraindication for keratorefractive procedures. Again, one of the other important things is that once the patient develops a cataract, the IOL power calculation is essential. No special formula is needed with the phakic implants. Thus, one can get more accurate results postoperatively. So I just like to conclude that there are obviously a large amount of advantages of the phakic IOL over the laser vision correction, which makes it my procedure of choice for even the low refractive errors. Thank you.